I feel great. It was a really tough heat. There wasn't many waves in the heat, and Kelly definitely got the jump on us. Luckily there was one come in the last 3 minutes there. I got it, and I'm just pretty stoked to get through that one.
I think Owen clearly got the better waves. That puts me out of the title race, but you know, what do you do? You know, one guy wins, one guy loses.
Did you film the whole heat or did you just watch?
Oh, I got most of it.
Because Kelly had a few barrels, didn't he?
It was a pretty exciting heat to watch from the beach. Kelly wasn't sitting still. He was certainly didn't want another example of what happened at Bells, you know. He was certainly on his game.
After taking down Slater at Bells this year, Owen went from strength to strength, having his best ever year on the WQS and qualifying for the 2010 ASP World Tour.
It panned out pretty well that start of the year. Just, it was all kind of confidence building, and then it just kept going through the year.
He's had a great, incredible year on the QS.
He's killing it at the moment. He's on the biggest roll, and he's just really exciting.
You know, he's matured a lot over the last few years, and he's going to be a great inclusion into the tour next year.
This year we've been to each and every event together. It's been a good year. I took a year off of work and he wanted us to hang around, and it's working out really well. I don't think I'll go back to work.
Yeah, it's good. I've had him along this year and it's a bit easier there having an older head to deal with some of the things that go on the road, so it's been great.
Yeah, he's definitely a family oriented person. He's always got his dad around him for support, and you know, his sister Tyler's like winning events, and it's a pretty cool little family.
I guess surfing, you could say, is in the family. We all do it, and I grew up in the New South Wales south coast at Culburra Beach. Down the south coast, it is known for reef breaks and bigger size swells, so it's definitely helped in that way. I guess it's all helped shaping my surfing, I guess.
He's got all the tricks, he does big turns, and the kid charges too, so he's going to be a really big asset for the tour next year and for years to come, for sure.
For the first time ever, the 2009 Rip Curl Pro Search Contest includes a stop of the ASP Women's World Tour.
We love including the women in our events, and it's a good thing for the sport, it's a good thing for the women, it's a good thing for the men, and it's a good thing for ASP and the tour. It's something that we hope to continue for, you know, next year and the years beyond.
I just thought maybe the search route, when I heard it was in Europe, might take me to France or Spain or something like that, but no, I'm really happy to be back here.
Yeah, the Rip Curl search events, it's really important for the girls to be on board, I think. It's cool that they're actually showing their really good support for the women's tour, and it's going to be good. I'm excited to see what happens.
Although not Super Tubos, the beach break at Belgas offered clean 3 to 4 foot waves for the early rounds of women's competition. Round one standouts included Melanie Bartels from Hawaii, whose 8-point ride secured the highest wave score of the day, edging out Alana Blanchard and Sam Cornish. Jessie Miley. revelled in the peak he left, with reigning two-time ASP Women's World Champion and current number one, Steph Gilmore, another standout in round one.
I guess first round you can kind of just shake it all off and, ease on into round three.
The surprise loss of the day was former ASP Women's World Champion Sofia Milanovic of Peru, beaten by an informed Chelsea Hedges.
Always good to be on the left. Can't complain.
After shifting wins destroyed the lineup and postponed competition, the following day, round two was greeted with beautiful, clean, 2 to 3 foot reeling left-handers. Avoiding elimination and moving into round three was Sofia Milanovic and Rosie Hodge.
It's always tough to be in round two, so it's sudden death, so definitely happy to get that one out of the way and looking forward to the next one.
With round three underway and a pulsing swell, the day was full of exciting surfing. Standouts included Steph Gilmore from Australia, who took down Megan Abubo from Hawaii. Brazilian Silvana Lima, who took the win in a close-fought heat with Jesse Miley Dyer. And young Tua rookie Sally Fitzgibbons, who scored the highest heat score of round three, a 17.67 out of a possible 20.
Just had a lot of fun out there, just sort of pulsed, and it was at least two wave steps each time and got a few scores.
It's not nice, Taylor.
Come on, brother.
Look how clean this car is, man. Jeez. Yeah. Awesome. Oh! Oh! I hope there's waves. Super Toots hasn't been very nice to us this whole trip, so I think it's about time.
We are currently on hold every 12 minutes. And so Tank and I decided to take the liberty of that 12 minutes and go to Super Toots. I walk through hell to see that face again, and I hope I will make it in the end. 'Cause guns can kill, they took my life away. Oh, we're out there. Hey.
Oh my God, that's the best wave I've seen. Hey, let's go play some volleyball first, though.
I got the same wetsuit. I got your wetsuit.
It looks really glassy, it looks really nice. But there's no one out there, and hopefully I get super cute. It's classic. He said he was having the shocker session, but he's still having like the time of his life, I swear. The guy's going over the falls in every wave.
You never know until you go, right?
It's kind of tripping out when we first came down here, and you can fully see the little banks and the potential of it, you know?
Oh, we weren't expecting anything, and it was, like, really fun. Well, that was one of the best days in the last 6 weeks I've had. This goes to show you what's going on. It's not much, but tomorrow they say it's going to be a lot bigger, so hopefully we'll get barreled.